If you're running an NVIDIA graphics card, open the NVIDIA control panel and click on the Manage 3D Settings menu. Then under Program Settings, where it says select a program to customize, look for Squadron 42 Star Citizen. If you can't find it, simply click the Add button and select it from the list. Here are three settings that will make the biggest difference. Number one, scroll to Power Management mode and select Prefer Maximum Performance from the drop-down menu. Then look for Triple Buffering and switch that to On. Now, just below that, you'll see Vertical Sync. Switch that to Fast. Next, we'll head over to the Global Settings and look for Shader Cache Size. Select 10GB from the drop-down. Note that the default is usually 4GB. You'll also see 100GB and an unlimited option. Some users report better frames per second in Star Citizen by using 10 as opposed to the other bigger options. Now just hit Apply and close the NVIDIA control panel. Now open the GeForce Experience. This step is particularly useful for lower-end systems. Head to Settings, then under the General tab, scroll down until you see image scaling and turn it on. Select the option that says 85%. This is pretty much DLSS for unsupported games, to put it in layman's terms. This can better your FPS in Star Citizen significantly, and the lower you set the percentage here, the better your frames per second will be, although you'll start losing image quality with anything below 85%. But by all means, sometimes you just gotta do what you gotta do.
Well, you know, you go out there and you give 110% and you want to play good and, you know, you hope you play good. I think we play pretty good tonight.